Mr. Tulsie says in the face of climate change, more storms, particularly strong forced storms, must be expected, and the onus is on the citizens of the island to deal with the new reality. And the director of the St. Lucia National Trust believes consideration need to be given to hazardous areas which are chosen to build homes.
Persons feel that they have the right to build wherever they own land. That's not the new reality with climate change. With climate change, we have to take into account where the hazardous areas are, and these hazard maps, I understand, are available, and to use those as guidelines.
Mr. Tulsie says building codes are not enforced. Furthermore, whilst he sees enforcing the building code as a challenge, waste management is also an issue. Mr. Tulsie believes, however, that it is no longer solely about prevention, but adaptation and how we build national resilience towards such issues.
It's part of a new reality we have to live with and plan for. And I believe that St. Lucians will have to cooperate with the government and with the planning authorities to ensure that proper guidelines are followed in construction, and that we leave adequate setbacks on our riverbanks, and to ensure that if there are floods, that homes are not taken away.
Major challenges have been faced by the St. Lucia National Trust in regards to conservation of the environment over the years. However, due to the passage of Hurricane Thomas, the St. Lucia National Trust believes that particular attention needs to be paid to climate change. In addition, the impact on tourism, he adds, hopefully will not be long-term, even if the environment was affected. The St. Lucia National Trust, Mr. Tulsie says, will continue advocating for sound environmental practices and sustainable development. Proposals will be sent soon to the government to discuss environmental assets and preservation. For the DBS News World, Jason Hollenseed reporting.